So my wife wants me to say hello, YouTubers. But instead, we're just going to cut right to culturing springtails, which are good janitors for trying to keep fungus out of your vivarium. Also, if you have poison dart frogs, they're a great side snack. So I've got a substrate. It's basically mulch I'm growing. I'm going to add distilled water. So we have a moist environment. They need humidity. Also, they eat fungus. There you go. Alright. So, to grow the mold, I've been aging strawberries. Aging by letting it sit in the back of the fridge. So I'm going to add these in. Eventually, they will grow something. Springtails are extremely tiny. These are tropical springtails.
Where are the springtails?
Oh, they ran away the second I opened it up. Well, I'm going to just add them in to the container. It's just a small plastic container. Oh, you can see the little white dots moving. It's a springtail.
Okay, yeah, I see them.
Now, they don't need much oxygen. But what they're eating produces plenty of CO2. It did cut in holes, placed in a little bit of screen, crisscrossing, two different layers. Of course, I don't really think it'll do much, but it's at least something to try to keep the springtails in.
So what's the purpose for growing the springtails?
They eat fungus and help recycle waste in your vivarium. They act as janitors. Plus, also, if your dart frogs need a snack, serve as a great little side snack. I wouldn't rely on them for too much calories, but they're a good start. Also, they can be kept alongside isopods, which are kind of like, well, they are pill bugs, potato bugs, roly-polies. I'll be ordering them later. They serve a similar function, only they don't eat mold, they eat decaying matter. But that is that.
Subscribe to our channel and like our videos.